Nice start to the day, Carl. A 7-1 advancing to declining stocks. All 11 sectors in the S&P were up, at least at the open. Take a look at the pre-open here, the futures here. And here's your, it's about 5-10. We moved up 12, 14 points here. That's where the point where we got word that China might be open to a partial deal. We have no idea what exactly that entirely means, but it moved the markets a little bit. And predictably, cyclical sectors, semiconductors, Melissa was talking about that earlier, on the upside. You can see here the China ETF. This is MCHI, which is the broadest China ETF, the one that I look at on a daily basis, up. Industrials up, materials, utilities lagging a little bit. So you see cyclicals up, defensive up, but lagging the overall market here. So the question is, and everybody kept asking me this morning, I don't know the answers, is this a truce or is this a trade deal or is it a little bit of both? What are we getting here? There's word that China might be open to a partial deal. We don't know exactly what that means, but apparently it means upping some agricultural purchases in exchange for no additional tariffs. So what is this? Is this a truce or a trade deal? I think the problem the market has with this overall is that the perception could be this is a truce, which means that the terms could change at any time in the near future. And that's not what the market wants. It wants a little more certainty. So in absence of this, and assuming this is essentially a truce kind of thing, and this is a good case scenario, the market narrative here with that in place was a truce, is that growth in 2020 will be lower. This is not the recession crowd. This is just the people think it'll be 1-2% GDP. Rates will be flat to lower. The leaders will remain largely defensive sectors, and earnings guidance will generally tend to trend lower. The question is, does it get significantly lower or not? But we've been using the word flattish all year. This is the market narrative. I'm not sure a truce will change the market narrative. You could see this in just what's been going on just in the last week and a half for October in terms of what's been moving the markets. The laggards are all the deep cyclicals, drillers, automobiles, electronic manufacturers, industrial conglomerates, agricultural products. This is just in the last week and a half. I could do the same thing if I put up a month or 2 months. It's essentially global cyclical names. The stuff that's been holding up better, of course, tend to be those defensive names. So home building's doing well. This is just, remember, the month, last week and a half. REITs tend to be flat. Pharmaceuticals are flat. Soft drinks are down 1%. Remember, the S&P was down almost 3% for the month going into the open today. So you can see very clearly how the market is reacting in a defensive manner. I'm not sure a truce is going to change that overall tone, that market narrative. As for the Fed minutes, there's a lot of comments there. Mike was talking about earlier. I'm not sure it's going to change anything because this was a long time ago, the Fed minutes. We've had weaker ISM surveys since that. We've had weaker consumer confidence. We had that whole repo market story everyone was talking about. I think the tone might sound a little bit hawkish for the minutes compared to the reality that we've got today. So I'm not sure how much value we're going to get out of the Fed minutes today. Finally, we've been talking about how tough the IPO market is. We've been talking about how tough it is to do work in China, for them to work here, us to work there. How about Chinese IPOs? You know, they're still floating around out there. There was one yesterday that was filed that may go public on the NASDAQ. We don't have the terms yet, but Fang Network Group, which is a Chinese company, it's an online real estate trading platform, they filed to go public, and they're going to list on the NASDAQ. That is the plan. We do not have any terms at all. But the point is, even in this kind of environment, there are still companies that are seeking to move forward on the IPO. We'll keep an eye on that and let you know what's going on. We're right at the highs for the day right now, Melissa, up 193 points.